seem to think is a modest step?
Well, first, as we said, following my conversations with the Prime Minister and with the Israeli government, this is a process. Israel's raised important questions about how humanitarian pauses would work. We've got to answer those questions. We're working on exactly that. In fact, we agreed that our teams would get together, and they're doing just that, including today, to work through the specifics, the practicalities of these pauses. Second, it's important that the pause advance a number of things. One of them is hostages. We are intensely focused, the United States, Israel, every other country that has one of its citizens being held hostage by Hamas, to bring them home. Now, it's important that as we're engaged in pursuing humanitarian pause, this can be something that advances the prospect of getting the hostages back. It can also advance other things that we're committed to doing, as is the government of Israel and other partners in the region, especially getting more humanitarian assistance to people who need it in Gaza. I'll remind you, when we had conversations 3 weeks ago about starting humanitarian assistance, it was a process to actually get that moving. But we had a commitment to do that. It took some days to get the process in place. Since then, we've had trucks moving. We have about 100 trucks a day going in. That's good, but it's grossly insufficient. So now we're working on raising that significantly so that more aid in a sustained way gets into Palestinians who need it. There again, humanitarian pause can also help advance that and create an environment in which we can do as much as possible for people who so desperately need the assistance. Yeah, I think everyone would welcome humanitarian pauses. There's no doubt about that. There are obviously different views, including on the question of the ceasefire, but there's no doubt from my conversations with all of our colleagues who were in Amman yesterday that everyone would welcome the humanitarian pause because, again, it can advance things that we're all trying to accomplish, including getting hostages back, including getting a lot more assistance into Gaza, including getting people out of Gaza. At the same time, it was very important to send a very clear message to anyone who might seek to take advantage of the conflict in Gaza to threaten our personnel here or anywhere else in the region. Don't do it. I made very clear that the attacks, the threats coming from militia that are aligned with Iran are totally unacceptable, and we will take every necessary step to protect our people. We're not looking for conflict with Iran. We've made that very clear, but we'll do what's necessary to protect our personnel, be they military or civilian. With regard to the visit to Ramallah and the Palestinian Authority, look, we are very focused on the day of, even as we need to be thinking about the day after. And I think what's clear is that with regard to the day after, with regard to future, Gaza, the West Bank, Palestinian views, Palestinian voices, Palestinian aspirations need to be at the center of that. And that's what we focused on. The PA is playing a very important role right now in the West Bank in trying to keep stability there. That's usually important because no one wants another front in the West Bank or anywhere else, and they're really stepping up under very difficult conditions to do the necessary work. But if you project forward to the future, what we all agree is that in defining that future, in shaping that future for Gaza, for the West Bank, and ultimately for a Palestinian state, Palestinian voices have to be at the center of that. The Palestinian Authority is the representative of those voices, so it's important that it play a leading role.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate you all very, very much. Thank you. Right here, sir. Over here at the start. Please, where we're in. Okay.
Thank you, sir. רוצה גם שתדעו שיש דבר אחד שאנחנו לא נעשה. לא תהיה הפסקת אש בלי החזרת חטופנו. שיוציאו את זה בכלל מהלקסיקון. אנחנו אומרים את זה גם לאויבינו וגם לידידינו. ואנחנו פשוט נמשיך עד שננצח אותם. אין לנו אלטרנטיבה.
يلا بعد الوقت
الحين بين الايمان الواحد على المحاك مش من وسع
حسبي الله
حسبي الله
حبيبي